Good evening, students. So welcome back to 12th biobotany class. Now we will see the zoophily. So last class we see that some of these bin pollinated and water pollinated plants. Now we will see the pollinated by animals. So pollinated by animal is called zoophily. Zoo means animal. Zoo means animal. So most of the plants are pollinated by animals are called zoophily. So which flower is involved in this pollination? They are called is an zoophilous flower. What's the name? Zoophily. This called flower is called is an zoophilous. So anemophilous and zoophilous. Anemophilous means pollination by wind. Then what are the pollinating agents in the zoophilous? So they are called birds, bat, snail, insect, ants, moths. So these are the examples of a pollinating agent. So these agents are well adapted in structure. Well adapted in structure. For example, hummingbird is a very sharp beak that bears the beak into the flower and sucking the honey. Sucking the honey. And some of the slugs and snails are also traveling on the flowers and other parts. They are also easily carrying the pollens from one flower to the another flower. So these zoophilous flower insects are also called well adapted in structures. And then some of the large animals like primates. Primates means a well developed advanced animal. Example, lemurs. It's a monkey like animal that is found in Madagascar area, that is only active in night time. Active in night time. This calls a primates. Example, lemurs. And then arboreal rodents. Arboreal means trees. Rodents, for example, squirrels. Some of these animals are also found in the trees. They are called as an arboreal rodents. And reptiles. Reptiles, that is a garden lizard. Garden lizard is a vonon. And Gecko lizard, these are the examples of large animals are also involved in the pollination by animal. Pollination by animal. Sometime ask this topic in a 3-mark question. What are zoophilous flowers or what is zoophily? So the zoophily is divided into 4 headings. One is called is an ornithophily. What's the name? Ornithophily. That is pollination by birds. So remember, all the technical terms are very difficult. Listen here. Ornithophily, that is involved by birds. By birds. So this flower we are called as an ornithophilous flower. And then sometimes the bats are also involved in the pollination. Example, that is called as an coffee. So there is a bat is a nocturnal animal. Only during the night time they are also searching their food. At the time, coffee, tea, this place are also, the pollen grains are also transferred from one flower to the another flower. This time is called as an cheiropterophily. What's the name? Cheiropterophily. That is called as an pollination by bats. And the next one is called as an molcophily. Molcophily means it takes place by snails and slugs. Snails, all of you know that snails and slugs. Some of these scraveling larval stages are also found on the plants. And mostly the pollination by insect is called as an entomophily. Insect is called as an entomophily. So some of the insect is also carried the pollens one flower and flower is called as an insect. That is a technical term is called as an entomophily. That flowers we are called as an entomophilous flower. So what are the general characteristic features of an ornithophily? Ornitho means birds. All of you know that a famous ornithologist, Salim Alim is a famous ornithologist. So this called is ornithophily. That term is called is ornithophily. So these flowers are very large in size because of when the flower also look like a large in size. These flowers are tubular. It look like a long tube and then cup shaped and wound shaped. Wound shaped means this like structure. It look like a long tubular like structure. This is a wound shaped structure. So these flowers are also tubular, cup shaped and a wound shaped structure, and then these flowers are brightly colored. It attracts for the birds, and then variously colored, for example hibiscus red in color, then manorhizum green in color. You see that some of the flowers are variously colored, red, bright violet, pink. These flowers are also attract the birds for pollination, and these flowers have scentless, there is no flower, there is no any smell, and produce nectar in large quantities. Nectar means honey that is observed, that is produced in a large quantities in the flower. So this collision, these flowers have a scentless, there is no smell, and the nectars also produced in a large quantity. So that is for that reason the birds are also attracts. And the pollen nectar formed in the floral. So these are the rewards for the attract of insects. So this calls visiting the flower, because some birds are also eating the pollen grain, nectar, the honey, that is attracting the birds are visiting for the pollination. And some of the plant flowers have tough and leathery floral parts. It's a very hard and thick in nature. When the birds are also sit on that flower, it withstand to the power to impact the visitors. That is called as an orchid flower, also larger in size. That is called as a leathery in nature. So this also helps in the pollination. So now we will see the various types of ornithophilias. That is called as a look here. Already we have seen the ornithophilia means a birds. Look here. Chiropterophily, the pollination by bats. Chiropterophily, pollination by bats. Example, Kygelia africana, and then Adsonia digitata. Kygelia africana, Adsonia digitata. Sometime ask in a one mark question, find odd one out or mismatched pair. So chiropterophily means pollination by bat, for example Kygelia africana, Adsonia digitata. And then molcophily, this also takes place by slugs and snail, especially for the Ericeae. Ericeae means that's a coconut family, that is a Ericeae. So these are also small flowers, but in a large in numbers. The snails and others are also traveling on this surface of the flower. That is, one flower to the another flower, easily they are pollinated by snails and slugs. For example, limna, this also pollinated by the snails and slugs. Example. And the next one is called Myrmecophily. Their pollination by ants. That is very important. Sometimes ask this one more question. Myrmecophily, pollination takes place by ants. Erumbugal moolam pollination pandru. And then canthrophily, it takes place by beetle. Canthrophily, pollination takes place by beetle. And balanophily, it takes place by moths. And melittophily, it takes place by bees. That is a honeybee. So already we studied in the previous portion, the study of a honeybee is called melittopalynology. So don't confuse these two words. Melittopalynology means study of a honey pollen is called as a melittopalynology, but melittophily means pollination by bees. And then psychophily, this also takes place by butterfly. So these are all the very important topics, but words are also difficult. You have to pronunciate more than 4 or 5 times, or if you read only two technical terms, sometime asking a match the following, find odd one out, mismatched pair. So this topic is a very very important, thoroughly prepared. Next subheading is entomophily. So pollination by insect is called entomophily. That flower is called entomophilia. entomophilus. So this is the most common type of pollination in angiosperm. So entomophily is a most common type of pollination in angiosperm. So the most of the pollination also takes place by insect. All of you know that, because a large number of insect is also carrying one flower to the another flower for sucking honey. It is naturally they are transferred one flower to the another flower. So what is the characteristics of entomophilous flowers? First one, the flowers are also large or small. If suppose the flowers are large in number, sometimes if the flowers are also very small but produced in a numerous, for example, Asteraceae, sunflower. All of you know that sunflower, it's a very big flower. That big flower is made up of a number of inflorescence. So when the inflorescence is, whether it is a large or a small, it is made up of a numerous inflorescence. All of you know that sunflower is a very big, then each one is called an inflorescence. So that is a housefly and other honeybees are also suck the honey from that flower. Example, Asteraceae. And then these flowers have a brightly colored, as like of a anemophilus. And floral parts are also brightly colored. Floral parts means a calyx, corolla, or nearby the leaves are also brightly in color. Why these parts are also brightly in color? Because of it attracts for pollination. For example, poinsettia. What's the name? Poinsettia. That is it belongs to Euphorbiaceae. So this is an ornamental plant. So some of the houses are also planting for attraction. When you see that flower is looking in a long distance, the younger leaves become a red in color. But actually the inflorescence is a green in color, but the younger leaves are also look in a red in color. Mature leaves are also green in color, poinsettia. The next one is called bougainvillea. What's the name? Bougainvillea. This Tamil name is kaagidappu. You look that, that's called bougainvillea, means kaagidappu. So these are also brightly colored, or floral parts are also attract for pollination. So these flowers are also scented. Scented means producing the smell. But anemophilous flower, there is no smell, scentless. But here also studied scented and producing nectar. So honey is also secreted. So there is no nectar in the flower. If suppose some of the plants there is no producing the nectar, what happened? The insect are also eating the pollen, eating the pollen, use it as a food for pollen. Sometimes it is used for the building up of a hive. Hive means a tenkud. Adu enna ona the pisin mari iruka pollen eduthu and eduthu enna ona kood katta payanpadum. So there is called a hive for honey bees. So sometimes there is no nectar produced in the flower. So some of the birds are also collecting pollen or consumed, used as a food, or used for building up of its hive for honey bees. So this is called as an important one. And then some of the plant flowers have juicy cells. Juicy cells means a succulent. Juicy means a succulent, and produced in which are piercely. For example, hummingbird, sunbird. So these are also pierce the beak into the deep, and they are also contain nectar, and honey is also sucked by the insect. So these are the some salient features of the entomophilous flower. That is given in your textbook. Only one example is given, pollination in salvia. Sometimes ask in a 3-mark question, how the pollination takes place in a salvia flower. So in pollination salvia, it shows liver mechanism. Liver, all of you know that, nembugol. This is a liver mechanism. So that is an salvia is adapted, pollination is adapted by bees. So in salvia, their pollination is adapted by bees. Honey bees and other sunbird miracle on the nadakum. So these flowers look like a, this flower is an protandrous. Protandrous means andrecium matured first and then gynecium matured later. That is called as a protandrous. So early andrecium matured very earlier than the gynecium. And corolla is a bilabiate. Bilabiate means ear udade idal. Look here, this is a one, then another one. So the corolla is a bilabiate. Then upper side and lower side. There are two type of corolla that is located at the upper side and lower side with two stamens. So this salvia flower is a protandrous. Corolla is a bilabiate with two stamens. So of these two stamens, the upper stamen is a long and fertile. Upper stamen is a long and fertile. Fertile means that producing the pollen grain. But the lower one is called as a short and sterile. This called as a sterile. These two stamens are also separated by long connective. These two are also attached by a connective. Which may helps in the anthers swings freely means these two stamens are also floating in the air because it's look like that. This bilabiate means this upper corolla, this lower corolla, in between this corolla the andrecium is attached by a connective, because the connective is also projecting outside. The andrecium is also swing freely. Easier than enna attach aanadanal காற்றுல அப்படின்னா அது பாட்டுக்கும் ஆடிக்கிட்டு இருக்கும். ஸோ when the bees visits the flower, what happens? These insects enter into the sit on the sterile stamens. What happens? So when the flower sit in this sterile stamen, it swings. So what happens? The fertile stamens are also moves downward or descended and to touch the back of the bees. What happened? So the pollen grains are shed on the back of the bees. So that insect is also sucking the insect from the nectar. So don't bother about that. But the surface of the body or surface of the bees, so falls on the pollen grain. So that after the sucking the honey, the birds or the bees are also leave away. What happened? So they are collecting the nectar from the another flower. So then again they are also go and sit on the another flower. What happened? So body of the insect is also completely pollen grain. So the stigma is also long and touching the back of the insect. So at the time the pollen grains are also reached this stigmatic lobe. So automatically the pollination by the bees takes place. So this is an important question, you have prepared thoroughly. அதாவது pollination in salvia அப்படின்னு கேட்டாலே என்ன சொல்கிறீங்க, liver mechanism, ஆஃப் மார்க் கொடுத்துருவாங்க. இட் இஸ் அடாப்டட் பை பீ பாலினேஷன். ரெண்டுக்கு சேர்ந்து என்னது ஆஃப் மார்க்கு கீழே கொடுத்துருவாங்க. டயக்ராம் போடணும், கண்டிப்பாக என்ன அது டயக்ராம் போட்டு லேபிள் பண்ணணும். அப்பர் குரலா, லோயர் குரலா, ஃபெர்டைல் ஸ்டேமன் அண்டு ஸ்டெரைல் ஸ்டேமன், லேபிள் தி பார்ட்ஸ். அதில் ஒவ்வொன்றும் எழுதுங்க, ப்ரொட்டாண்டஸ் என்ன, கொரோலா என்ன, எத்தனை ஸ்டேமன் இருக்குது, என்னது இந்த ஷார்ட் ஃபார்மை ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கிட்டு எழுதுனிங்கன்னா ஈஸியாக மார்க் கொடுத்துருவாங்க. இதுக்கான ரொம்ப இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் க்வெஸ்சன், படிச்சுங்க. அண்ட் நவ் வி வில் சீ தி சம் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் அண்ட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் பாலினேஷன் பை பீஸ் ஆர் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் டெக்னிக்ஸ் யூஸ் என்ன பாலினேஷன். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் கால்ஸ் அ ட்ராப் மெக்கானிசம். ஸோ நவ் வில் சீ சால்வியஸ் கால்ஸ் லிவர் மெக்கானிசம். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் கால்ஸ் அ ட்ராப் மெக்கானிசம். Example, Aristolochia. This plant is also found in the hedges. What in the hedges? வேலைகள் அதிகமாக இந்த பிளான்ட் இருக்கும். பார்த்தீங்கன்னா உரி மாதிரி என்ன அதோடைய காய் தொங்கிக்கிட்டு இருக்கும். அதுக்கான ஒரு ட்ராப் மெக்கானிசம். அண்டு ஃபிட்பால் மெக்கானிசம். ஃபிட்பால் நடத்தும் குளிக்கில் உழுகிறது. குளிக்கில் என்ன பொலங்கிறேன்ஸு உள்ளிருந்து வெளியில் வராது. ஃபிட்பால் மெக்கானிசம். எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆரம் அண்ட் கொலகேசியா. ஆரம் கொலகேசியா. ஆனால் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா நம்ம ஏற்கனவே அந்த பிளான் நம்ம படிச்சிருக்கோம். அண்டு கிளிப் ஆர் டிரான்ஸ்லேட்டர். ஸோ ஆல்ரெடி ஸ்டடி இன் தி ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் ஆஃப் பொலன் கிரெயின் இன் தி ப்ரீவியஸ் டாபிக். கிளிப் ஆர் டிரான்ஸ்லேட்டர். எக்ஸாம்பிள் அஸ்கிளிப்பியாடேசி ஃபேமிலி. இட் இஸ் பிளான்ட் இஸ் கலிசன் கலோட்ராபிஸ். already seen pollinium, corpusculum, reticulum, already studied in the, this called clip or translator mechanism. And then last is called the piston method. Piston method, that is another, a gun mari another vegama poi seiyrom. Example, papilionase. Example, papilionase. Adhaadu vannathu poochi padi illa malargala pathi vechukom. Crotalaria, legume family. Legume family, there most of the pollinase takes place by piston method. So this also asking in a match the following or find odd one out or mismatch the pair. So all the words are very difficult. You don't bother about that. You have to prepare every day two headings. Every day two headings you are thoroughly prepared it. Enna paathukitta enna idhu ivlo kashtama irukku words or kashtama irukku nenikkanukiradhu illa. So take your books and read more than two times or three times. Take hints and prepare well. Or again you will see and see and see again the video session, you will understand. So prepare it. All of you submit your worksheet. Then Monday onwards we will send the second worksheet. Within a 2 days you have to submit it. Don't delay. So don't copy it from the textbook. When you open the textbook, what are the topics are given, read thoroughly and close the textbook and then answer it. You don't bother about the mark, you try to the best. Thank you.